Welcome back, everybody. This is Red Halo here, and we're playing more Final Fantasy X. Last time we went and did the Cloister of Trials and fought one of Sin's things before that and got pushed and had to do it by another summoner, I guess. Anyway, we're back here and we're heading this way, I assume. Just heading back to where we were before, which is the awesome-ass village here. And I don't know, I guess we're going towards the pier or whatever. No, that's not the right way. Maybe this way. Embark? Yeah, let's embark.
Off to Luca at last. The matches start soon as we get there. So rest up on the way, yeah?
Wait, are we gonna play Blitzball when we get there? I'm excited! We're going across the map. What? All the players down here. I'm like, nah, I don't want to sit down anymore. I'm gonna just sit over here. Tournament's coming up real soon. Wish we could have more time to practice. Yeah? They all say yeah. I just want to sneak up behind them and beat them. I mean, I want to get in their face and show them what we're made of. I didn't say yeah, at least. Why do we have to be on the same ship as those Lucans anyway? Here's a chest, which a high potion. I like to see. Anything else on the side?
Ugh, why do I feel like I'm being watched?
Heal up again. What's this way?
It might not mean much, but good luck in the tournament.
Okay.
Best to let him sleep.
Who's in there? I don't know who's in there. We came through here, right? Oh, no, but just let's go through there. I didn't even press the button as long as go through. Huh. Let's go up, I guess. Let's go up again.
Say something. You'll take responsibility.
Relax. He's bound to know someone in Luca.
And if not?
He could always join a Blitz team. Anyhow, it's better than just leaving him in Bisade.
What? Just leaving him in Luca?
What do you want me to do?
Yuno wants to make him a guardian.
Oh, yeah, jeez. There's that too, eh?
And
talk about me behind
that?
My back.
Not mine. It is mine, huh?
Interesting. Okay. Can we go in here? Yes, we can. Oh, is that a Albed primer? Yes, it is. Volume 5. Whee! We're good. And what is it? A equals E. Very nice. Let's talk with this dude. No offense, but I'm a diehard Luca Goers fan here. Good luck, pal. You're going to need it. Oh, well, thanks a lot, bud. They still up here talking about me?
Why do you think she wants to make him a guardian anyway?
Because he's Sir Jack's son.
All right. Wait, you sure about that? He's really Sir Jack's son.
It's hard to say, but Yuna seems to believe so.
Why don't you just listen to me? I've said it before, yeah.
Okay. That's all you have to say?
Well, yeah, I mean,
He's got to decide for himself, yeah? Well, him and Yuna, yeah. I guess.
You're right, for once. I wonder which is best.
Wonder if I go down, then go back up. Yep, listen to him still.
Should what?
Become Yuna's guardian.
Why me?
Because Yuna can't.
Why not?
He hates his father. What he was, what he did. Do you really think she can possibly say to him, I want you to be my guardian, like your father was to mine?
Aren't you being oversensitive? All right, all right. I'll try talking to him after the tournament.
Be discreet.
I know. It's his decision.
One more time, maybe? No, why don't they just continue then? Why?
Apparently, he told Yuna as much.
Hating your own father, huh? Sounds like a luxury to me. I don't even remember my parents. Can't say how I feel about them.
I was 5 then, so I remember mine a little.
Damn it! Sin just takes everything away from us.
Oh, we can actually go up now, so I guess that's over. What? Is Yuna available to talk? Actually, there's a blitz ball here. Apparently, we're gonna do something with it. There's Jet. Oh my god. There's that kid again. What? Look over there, right there.
Well, well. Trying to follow in my footsteps, are you? I usually charge for lessons, you know. That shot is done like this. You can't do it,
what?
Kid. But don't worry.
No one could do it. That's impossible.
You're not the only one. No one else can do it. I'm the best.
Yeah, are you really? The Jet Shot Challenge. Press up, press over, press X. Press the buttons in the following on-screen instructions. Boom, boom, X, over to the side. All right, let's try it. So Jet, you can do it.
You're out of your league. No one else can. I'm the best. You're out of your league. No one else can. You're out of your league. You're out of your league. You're out of your league. You're out of your league.
I don't think we did it. Oh no, we did do it.
Huh.
Damn! I thought I missed a few of them, right. But okay.
Huh? Whoa! What's that called?
Doesn't have a name. Anyone can do it if they try.
Show us one more time, yeah?
Let's do it one more time. Do I have to do my thing again? Or does he just do it?
Hi.
I hope he's just gonna do it. Okay. Interesting. Well, let's go talk with her, I guess.
That was the jet shot, wasn't it?
How do you know that?
Sir Jekt showed it to me when I was a child. He called it the sublimely magnificent Jekt Shot Mark III.
What?
stupid name, huh? You know what? There is no Mark 1 or Mark 2, you know? My old man said the name Mark 3 was just something to hook the crowd. He said they'd come back every night expecting to see Mark 1 and Mark 2. And they really did come back. I used to get so mad. Is he alive, you think?
I don't know. But Sir Jekt was my father's guardian.
So he's famous here, too?
Yes. So if anything happened to him, I should think word would get around fast.
Uh-huh.
What would you do if you found him?
Who knows? I thought he died 10 years ago. Well, I'd probably just smack him one. After everything he put Mom and me through. And because he was famous, I was always... Well, you should know, Yuna.
Hmm?
Your father's famous, too. Everyone in Spira knows him, right?
Hmm.
Ain't it tough?
What's wrong with your hands, buddy?
It is hard to follow in his footsteps as a summoner.
Sure.
But the honor of having a father like him surpasses all that, I think.
Well, there wasn't much to honor about my old man, that's for sure.
You shouldn't say that about your father.
I got the right.
I guess you do.
Ow!
Show me that move again!
Yo! I didn't think my old man would come to Luca. He never did like watching other people play. But I couldn't help feeling something bad was gonna happen. And these feelings of mine are usually right. Sure, I had told Waka I'd help him win the tournament, but I wasn't sure I had it in me to play at all anymore.
Oh, there we go. He's sleeping again. Save current game? Sure. New save. Yes. Good. Alrighty. Ooh, it's that terrible hair again. Yevon.
And this year we celebrate Maester Micah's 50th year in office.
Ah, over there. The ships carrying the players are arriving now. This would be dock number 2. All the way from Killika, it's the Killika Beasts. High Summoner O'Holland used to play for them. Big name to live up to. Their hometown was recently attacked by Sin. Isn't that right, Jimma?
Yes, Baba. They're gonna be pulling out all the stops to try and bring back the cup this year.
Exciting, isn't it, folks? Our next team on the ramp is... Well, well, well. If it isn't the Bassade Aurochs. They're a living, breathing, statistical impossibility. I've never seen a team this bad.
Oh my god.
That's right. In 23 years, they've never made it past the first round.
Well, that's gonna change today.
Only a few diehard fans are in the audience today.
Best of luck to them and a safe journey back to Bassade.
Wow.
Right, Jimmy. Moving right along, our next team is... Here they are, folks. Our very own Luca Goers.
Goers? That's just an awful name.
They've got speed. They've got teamwork. They're an all-round first-class team, and they're back home in Luca.
Without a doubt, they are the favorite this year, Baba. And after the way they dominated last year, it'd take a miracle for them to lose today.
You can say that again, Jimma.
I'm gonna just use the jet shot on them like crazy. Or whatever Titus wants to call it.
It's like this every year, yeah? Don't let it bother you.
Too bad. It's bothered me.
Stop right there, goers!
What?
This is nuts. Smiling now, but not for long! Cause this year, us Aurochs are taking the cup!
This is nuts.
What in Yevon's name were you doing up there?
We sure stood out, though.
We were on the sphere.
We were?
Maester Micah is here.
Already?
The number three dot.
What's up now?
Maester Micah has arrived, that's what.
Micah? Maester?
Maester Micah is the leader of all the peoples of Spira. He's come all the way from Bavel. The tournament is being held to honor his 50 years as Maester.
Wow. 50 years? Shouldn't he be, retired by now?
Hey, mind your mouth now.
Let's all go see him.
Alrighty. Well, first things first, heal our team up. Don't know what's coming. So... maybe we can go this way? Nope. Okay. Trying to call the bad mad rush. That's fine, buddy. We're just gonna look around here for a second. Maybe there's stuff we can pick up. Tap an X all over, but doesn't look like there is, so off to the red arrow.
Can't see a thing.
Shh.
Seen that guy
That's
before.
A grotto, right?
Who could it be?
Isn't that Maester Seymour?
Yeah, I've heard that name before. He already does not look like a friend.
People of Spira, I thank you for your generous welcome. Rise, Maester Seymour, and all of you as well. I present to you the son of Maester Jiskel Guado, who departed for the far plain a fortnight past. As some of you already know, he has been officially ordained a Maester of Yevon.
Yevon.
I am Seymour Guado. I am honored to receive the title of Maester.
In What's life, wrong with his face?
My father Jiskel worked to foster friendship between man and Guado. I vow to carry on his legacy and to fulfill my duties as Maester to the best of my abilities.
Hmm.
You too, bow your head.
He's got a weird costume. What the hell?
Really psychs you up, yeah? All right, last meeting before the match. Hustle.
Okay. Save current game. We don't need to save. We saved earlier. What?
Where's Waka?
At the matchup draws.
We had to play the Goers in the first match last year.
The year before that, and the one before that, too.
Well, we would have lost to anyone anyway.
Don't say that.
Get Waka!
We're playing the Albed Sykes first. If we win, we're in the finals.
How many teams are there?
That's
four?
Right. We got seeded. Two wins, and we're the champions.
What?
First things first. Let's go over the basics again, boys.
Oh, no. You're just doing this for me. Basics. Holy cow. Oh, we're going to have to do all of them. We want to win, so. Five players per team in the sphere pool. Overhead map shows the players' current positions and the direction each is facing. Here, only one team is shown on the field. Tyus is carrying the ball right now. The ball carrier is displayed as the circled arrow on the map. Now let's watch the players move. You have HP? It may seem confusing at first, but it's actually quite simple. Really. By default, player movement is set to auto, so everyone moves around the pool automatically. Use the overhead map to check the player's positions. Triangular frame inside of the red circle is the opposing team's goal. Okay. Here it is. The goal is always on the left side, hand side of the overhead map. Let's resume. Try to keep track of your position to the goal. Let's try moving the ball carrier manually. Press triangle. Now you've enabled manual movement. Press to move the player manually. Okay. Only the ball carrier can move manually. All the other players stay in manual. Okay. The camera is really messing me up. Note that it becomes hard to manage your teammates while manually controlling the carrier. This mode is recommended for veteran blitzers. I'm not a veteran blitzer. Never played it before in my life. Now you're back to auto movement. Okay. Try switching between manual and auto to get a feel for both. Okay. In manual A mode, the direction of the movement corresponds to the overhead map. Over moves the player towards the opposing team's goal, towards the other. Okay. In addition to manual A, there is also a mode called manual B stick, which with auto movement for now. Okay, whatever. Movement modes are only applicable when you're on offense, but when you're on defense, your entire team moves on auto. Okay. Use the overhead manual. Okay. I got the summary. Action commands. It's going to take a while. Action command menu by pressing square. Press square now. Pass, shoot, costs HP. The game pauses while the action command open is window. Command window is open, so you have ample time to take your next move. This is explained where pass explained elsewhere. Please select dribble. Dribble. There are three available commands. Pass, shoot, dribble. Dribble simply makes the player resume movement. Pass and shoot are the most important commands. Okay. Passing. Now let's take a look at passing. Press square. Okay. Select pass. Pass to Datto. Tyus throws a pass. Your pass complete now. Dado has the ball. Stats determine the outcome of each pass. Take a look at the number shown next to PA. That number, 10, represents Stato's passing accuracy. Let's pass the ball back to Titus. Press square. Okay. Pass to Titus. Okay, so it went down. The friction of the water causes the pass to gradually decrease. Reaches zero, the pass becomes uncatchable. How do I know how far something is away? Press square to pass the ball. It's only 3. Tyus throws a pass. Okay. When a pass fails, the ball becomes loose. A loose ball can be claimed by anyone. Therefore, a player with high PA can successfully throw longer passes. Likewise, a player with low PA often throws bad passes, giving the other team a chance to get the ball. Okay. Shooting. Let's look at shooting. Very similar to passing. Player's shooting accuracy is SH. Has 10 right now. A shot that reaches the goal with SH at least 1 will score. If a shot's SH is depleted, it will fail. Goalkeeper defends the goal from Tyus' shots. Okay. Let's get closer first. Now we can shoot. Select shoot. Goalkeeper stats are beneath you. Your teammate's stats are displayed on the blue background. The opposing team's on the red. Okay. Simple enough. CA represents the goalkeeper's ability to catch incoming shots. In this example, Rowdy's goalkeeping ability is shown as 8. Let's resume. Keep an eye on the SH. He's going to obviously catch it. Since it lost some HE to travel through the water, it's currently at 7. Here we take a shot. Take the shots at SH, subtract the goalkeeper. Okay, so our SH has to be higher than CA. Ranging from 50 to 150%. Here the goalkeeper CA is 8, so the actual amount subtracted may vary from 4 to 8. So let's see whether the SH will score. It did score. What? I don't know. That's so confusing to me. Now we have 4. Let's get even closer. Now it's pretty much impossible that we miss. Let's shoot. What? See, that is dumb. That is super dumb. We should have, without a doubt, made that. We were 2 inches away from the goal. Okay. Using HP. Perform actions as HP. Think of it as stamina. Okay. Whoever has the ball steadily loses HP while carrying it through the water. Yeah, I see it. Okay. Decreases when the ball's carried. Shooting pass and also consume HP. Each shot, 10, loses 10 for shooting. As you can see up front from 26 to 16, I do see that somehow he caught it. Okay. We weren't very close, so that makes sense. When they do, their shots are only half as effective, so Whenever it's low, note that. Let's pass. Oh, we want to shoot? Okay, fine. Yeah, I knew he was going to catch it. Duh. When they get rid of the ball, they regain their HP. Okay, fine. What else are we going to here? Encounters? Alright, let's see what encounters occurs when opposing players come in contact with the ball carrier. If you are the ball carrier, the action command menu will open. You must then decide of the course of action. Okay, so for now, select no break. We'll explain breakthroughs later. No break. Okay. Now set pass. Okay. Lose PA as it travels through the water. But in an encounter, your opposing player tries to block your passes and shots. Okay. BL represents the player's skill at blocking. It's at 2. Okay. The plus loses the amount of PA equal to the BL. The actual calculation is slightly randomized. PA falls below or falls to 0 or less, the ball is intercepted. PA 10 and BL 2, estimated result is 8. As long as PA is at least 1, the pass goes through. Okay, that makes sense. Pass to Dado. Gets a hand on it. We caught it. We're good. The defender reduced the PA of the pass when he got a hand on it. Okay. Now we're going to see what it looks like when it's higher. Okay. 18. No break, I guess. Let's shoot. Why not? Oh, we have to pass. Letty, let's pass it to you. You haven't had it yet. Grab the ball. Of course you did. Multiple defenders. So they're both on defense. No break. So you have to add both of them. So 6. We still would be able to pass it, right? Letty again. Yeah. But can you catch it? No, you can't because you fumbled the ball. Holy cow, there's so much to learn. Try shooting a goal with 2. Okay. No break. Shoot. Okay, we gotta subtract the show beneath SH, current value, all this stuff. You totally missed. But you're gonna catch it, yep, because we had 0. I know that. Alright, breakthroughs. We still got a little while to go. Holy cow. Okay, let's do it. Breakthroughs. We got 3 guys on us right now. 3 opposing players. PA resents the accuracy. Here's PA. We're 17 right now. 11 plus 5 plus 3 is less than 0. Yeah, because that's 18. Let's try a breakthrough. Let's try breaking through Grav. Keep an eye on Grav's AT during the breakthrough. So his is 7 and we're 11. So we have to break through him. Okay. Grav will tackle Titus. Titus can't if he can't withstand it, he'll give the ball up. It takes endurance to withstand tackles. We're 11, so we'll be fine. Let's pass. You tackled hard, but we're fine. We endured it. Look at the stats shown underneath PA. Since Grav is out of the picture, he can't block passes anymore. The math is now 17 minus 8, so completing a pass should be easy now. Passes to Jasu. Yeah, we got it. See? Breakthrough before you other make other commands. That makes sense. Okay. Tick copy. Okay. God, there's so much to know. Players can learn techniques from their opponents. It's called tech copy. First have one of your players mark an opponent who knows a desirable technique. Now the player will keep an eye on the opponent in order to learn it. Select break to brisks in here. Okay. This indicates the window of opportunity to learn the technique. Press X at the right time in order to learn it. Select dribble for now. Okay. We learned it. Titus is poisoned. Tech copy failed. Just remember that the player who learns the technique is not necessarily the one to be used it against. Players who have marked that opponent are the ones who learn this technique. If multiple players have marked him, only one will learn at a time. Okay. Your players may have trouble learning techniques, though, if you have lower levels than respective targets. Once you've learned a new technique, you can equip it at halftime or at the start of the next match. Golly, there's so much to know. Stats. HP. Okay, we already know this. Endurance, ability to withstand tackles. Okay. PA, passing accuracy. And SH, shooting. AT, attacking strength. BL, blocking strength. CA, goalie. Techniques. Status ailments. Poison. Poison accelerates the loss of HP. That makes sense. Also, disables techniques. Alright, sleep. Because unable to act, the player will wake after a while, but only as hit by the ball. Wither. Reduces a single stat by half. Okay. And then we got techniques. You can learn blitzball techniques by telecopying them from opposing players or by using prizes given to the top teams of each tournament. Initially, each player can only learn one certain techniques. But by learning certain key techniques, a player can increase the number of techniques available to him. The required key techniques vary by player. Each time a player learns a key technique, he gains access to a broader range of techniques. Game modes. 10 games are played during a league season, with the winner determined by total points. 3 points are rewarded for a win, 1 a tie, and you can press triangle to forfeit a game. Tournaments span 2 or 3 matches. There are no draws, so a match ending with a tie scores goes into overtime. Okay. Exhibition games are for practice. No experience. Alright, we're done, finally. That took forever. I think I get kind of it. I'm in the same boat as you right now, Titus.
There you are. Someone said they saw Sir Orin in a cafe.
Orin?
What?
Yes, Sir Orin. Let's go find him.
Let's go find him. Hell yes.
Hey! The game starts like real soon. You come back quick, yeah?
Hey, I'll be back.
I'll be back.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, Waka. You're stiff, man. No, not your face. Just breathe out. Okay. Like this. Just breathe. Yeah.
That was funny.
Maybe now we can find Sir Jekt.
Huh? How?
No, I don't want to find him. What are you kidding?
Sir Orin was also my father's guardian. So, he might know where Sir Jekt is.
Let's go now.
Let's go.
It didn't even occur to me to think that the Aran Yuna was talking about and the one that I knew from Xanarkand could be two different people. I don't know why, but I knew it was the same guy. I knew it was the same Aran.
It is the same Aran, I can tell you that. We can go in here. There's a save point. We're going to save and end this episode now. Yes, I do want to save. Good. Very good. Well, guys, thanks for watching. This was a good episode. We're at Lucia now, or wherever. Luca. And we learned all about Blitzball. Took a while, but now when we go and do a match, probably next episode, we'll know what we're talking about, what we're doing. So, anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Hit this like button on the video. It helps me out a great deal. Also, if you want to watch more Final Fantasy X or anything else on my channel, hit the subscribe button as well. And anyway, guys, this is Red Halo. Peace out.